ब्लाइंडनेस मतलब नो नीड ऑफ लाइट। आपको 24 आवर्स एक लाइट है, उसमें कभी डार्कनेस नहीं है। योर आपके लाइफ में कभी अंधेरा नहीं होता, दैट इज ब्लाइंडनेस।
We know the world as we see it. Sunlight, stars, moonlight, and other innumerable specks of luminance have made their way into our lives with such immeasurable ease, we never stop to think what it would be like to live a life without light. A life without shapes, faces, a life without colors. It often takes an extraordinary revelation to extend the ordinary boundaries of our imagination. What does a blind person see? Will there ever be a way of knowing it?
When I got oriented with blind photography, I was really interested because I wanted to see a visual world in my way.
मुझे सब कुछ याद है पर मैं एक्सप्रेशंस भूल गया हूँ, तो मेरे कैमरा से मुझे एक्सप्रेशंस कैच करने हैं। मीन्स मैं देख नहीं सकता पर मैं दिखा सकता हूँ।
Known as a predominantly visual art, photography has been embraced by several blind people across the world, not just as a means of communication, but also as a profession. In India, in 2004, Partho Bhomik began one of the first projects with blind photographers, known as Blind with Camera.
The Blind with Camera project started in 2004. When I got hold of a magazine and उसमें एक article था about a French blind photographer and that was a seed actually. So I established a contact.
Having established contact with French blind photographer Evgan Bafka and many other blind artists around the world, Partho began conducting workshops for the blind in Mumbai and other cities of India. He also has a unique concept of teaching blindfold photography to sighted people, aiming to give them insight into the dark world.
I have come to the stage where I have taught more than about 100 blind people, and each time I teach them, there is a stronger belief in me that there is a sight at the core of darkness.
भूल जाओ भूल को अगर भूल हो अनजान की, मत करो उस बात को जो बात हो एहसान की। मंजिले हो दूर हो रास्ता कठिन तो मत डरो, जूझ कर हैरानियों से वीर की सांसें भरो। साय में गम के घने सुख की उम्मीदें नित करो, मौत पर भी मुस्कुराने की असीम हिम्मत करो।
Traditional concepts of photography like composition and color may mean nothing to a visually impaired photographer, and yet their innate sense of aesthetic is very apparent in every picture they take.
Color doesn't mean anything to me. I can only imagine colors such as black and white, not more than that. Black for me would mean that there's complete darkness. And white would mean some kind of shine.
आपको दिखता है तो आप अंधेरे में डिस्टर्ब हो सकते हो, हमको अंधेरे उजाले से कोई मतलब नहीं है। हमारे जो विजन है वो क्लियर है 24 आवर्स के लिए।
Seeing according to you would be just seeing with the eyes. What I see according to you is nothing at the present. It's blank. You are a ghost. I just hear a voice coming from that end. But for what I can see, I know you're there. I know the cameraman is there and I know somebody else is there. There are three people opposite me. So I can see three. What you think I can see is nothing.
When we have sight, we are distracted with a lot of things. And these guys with no sight or very limited sight, their other senses are very focused.
Bhavesh Patel, blind since childhood, has no knowledge or memory of color or the sighted world whatsoever. Photography to him is a means of understanding the visual world, which is hidden from him. He loves photographing St. Xavier's College, Mumbai, where he studied political science because he is fascinated by the textures of the stone walls and has heard from his friends that the college resembles a London university.
I don't feel the loss of sight. Suppose agar do nalon mein pani beh raha hai aur agar ek nal ko stop kiya jaye to dusre nal mein jis tarah se pani ka bahav thoda badh jata hai usi tarah mera bhi sight na hone ki wajah se aisa lagta hai ki mere baaki senses thode strong ho gaye hain. हम कबूतर खाना गए थे. बारिश गिर रही थी बहुत सारी. There were pigeons flying in the sky. और उस टाइम पे मुझे जैसे ही उनकी आवाज़ सुनता हूँ मुझे पिक्चर क्लिक करनी थी. सो इट वॉज अ चैलेंजिंग जॉब बिकॉज आई हैव नेवर डन दिस काइंड ऑफ थिंग अर्लियर इन माय लाइफ.
यूजिंग देयर सेंस ऑफ हियरिंग, टच, स्मेल एंड एन इंट्यूटिव सिक्स्थ सेंस, दीज फोटोग्राफर्स आर एबल टू कंपनसेट फॉर द लॉस ऑफ साइट व्हेन टेकिंग अ पिक्चर. नीडलेस टू से, their ability to compose a picture depends on skills beyond the understanding of a sighted photographer.
See, for sighted photographer, we only look for visual things. But I would say anything which is something different for me, I would click a picture image without a thinking of it. So not having a vision is, I think, a strength for me. And that is a strength for me as a photographer also.
I sometimes think that because maybe I have the ability to look at things, I have sight, that I am short-sighted or I don't use my other senses well.
An acupressure therapist and a professional sitar player, Mahesh began to lose his eyesight from the age of 2. He was also the first student of the Blind with Camera project.
आपको अगर कोई चीज का फोटो लेना है, आपको अगर मेरा फेस कैच करना है, तो आप पूरी कोशिश करेंगे कि मेरा फेस ही आए और कुछ ना आए. पर हम लोग जब करते हैं तो हमारी भी कोशिश होती है कि मेन फोकस फेस पे रहे, लेकिन कई बार बैकग्राउंड उसके साथ आ जाता है. इट्स क्वाइट, यू कैन से इट्स एक्सपेरिमेंटल पार्ट के साथ में कुछ आ जाता है तो कई बार वो खूबसूरत हो जाता है.
Photography is a way to look for what you would like to find. When you take a picture, it is both a sense of what you allow in the frame as to what you keep out.
मेरा एक फोटो है, धूप और छाव के टेम्परेचर को जज करते हुए मैंने वो फोटो लिया है. जो फुटपाथ पे ब्रांचेस से जो डिज़ाइन बनी है पेड़ की, उसका वो फोटो है और उसमें किसी के फुट स्टेप्स आ गए हैं तो वो काफ़ी अट्रैक्टिंग हो गया. तो आई थिंक वो विजन नहीं होने की वजह से आया. विजन होती तो शायद नहीं आता.
दिस पिक्चर टाइटल डिजाइनर शैडो इज टेकन बाय महेश उमरानिया. ऑन मूविंग योर फिंगर्स फ्रॉम द लोअर लेफ्ट टू द लोअर मिडिल पार्ट ऑफ द पिक्चर, यू कैन फील द शैडो, द ब्रांचेस एंड द लीव्स. बाय टचिंग द मिडिल ऑफ द पिक्चर, यू कैन फील वेयर द शैडो इज एंडिंग. ऑन मूविंग योर फिंगर्स टूवर्ड्स द अपर राइट कॉर्नर, यू विल फाइंड द लेग्स ऑफ टू पीपल.
It's the perfect picture, actually. You see the perfect stance of these passers-by. I would consciously want to take this picture. It never happens.
गर्मी के दिन थे, काफ़ी धूप थी. तो जैसे पेड़ के नीचे मैं पहुंचा, मैंने छाव को फील किया. मतलब मैं समझ गया कि कुछ डिज़ाइन नीचे ज़रूर बनी होगी, क्योंकि डालियों के बीच से धूप गिर रही थी. तो एक टेम्परेचर से लिया हुआ जजमेंट था. और फिर मैंने सर को गाइड लेकर इसको क्लिक किया.
It's a fun picture. This is what I like to do. It's about looking at life more than life. This gentleman is a security guard who's holding up a magnifying sheet and it magnifies its face. It makes everyone laugh, it makes everyone smile, it makes a good picture.
Kanchan lost complete eyesight 11 years ago. Since then, she has been taking photography excursions with Blind with Camera and loves to shoot through self-made pinhole cameras made with matchboxes and pipes, among other things.
I was reading the paper one morning, actually my mom was reading it to me, and there was this little write-up, somebody saying that he wanted to teach photography to the visually challenged. It was a shocker. I picked up the number, called him immediately, and that's how I made friends with Bart. Of course, I told him he's crazy, but then we have come a long way from then.
I would often imagine how, say, a person who doesn't have sight would be, why would that person be compelled to take pictures? It seems absurd as to why he would he be interested or she would be interested in doing this. I don't know exactly why, but I can relate to it. It's the same desire to reach a clearing for yourself.
लोग ये सोचते हैं कि दिखता नहीं तो करते क्यों हैं? हम करते हैं इसलिए हैं क्योंकि हम तो नहीं देख सकते हैं, पर ये हमारे पास है कि हम नहीं देखते फिर भी आपको दिखा सकते हैं. आप शायद हमको नहीं दिखा सकते लेकिन हम आपको दिखा सकते हैं.
When I was young, I had a camera or a couple of them, but I wasn't good at photography because I couldn't see what I was clicking very well. I had low vision, so I couldn't see very well. I was interested, but there was nobody to guide me through that process.
I've been asking them this question on and off. What you get out of this project. They take a lot of pride in doing this work. Pictures that they take, they can share it with your friends, right? And with the social media and all that, it can spread even beyond the immediate circle. Well, they are creating an image. There are a lot of soft skills that they acquire. The first one, they are given a challenge to communicate, right, through a photograph. The second is their senses get focused in the process. Right. They are also given a challenge of a time frame to do it and a teamwork to work.
Just as there is little awareness about photography for the blind, there is also a large amount of resistance to the concept. A lack of understanding about the methods of blind photography leads people into disregarding its possibility altogether.
लोगों के क्वेश्चंस तो बहुत तरीके के होते हैं. कुछ लोग कहते हैं कि आप रनिंग सीन का फोटो किस तरह से क्लिक करोगे. बट आई थिंक आई हैव सीन, आई हैव शोन देम एन एग्जांपल, और मुझे ऐसा नहीं लगता कि ये इम्पॉसिबल चीज है.
वंस आई हैड अ केस व्हेन माय स्टूडेंट वाज लिटरली ड्रॉपिंग आउट इन ऑल द वर्कशॉप्स एंड फाइनली ही केम टू द वर्कशॉप. देन आई आस्क्ड हिम कि क्या हुआ तुमसे, क्यों नहीं आ रहे हो तुम वर्कशॉप में. He told me that when he was coming out of for the workshop, his mummy told him, "Yaar, kya tum andhe ho? Tum kya photography ke liye time waste karte ho?" They have a power to create an image in their mind, but that image never had a purpose to communicate outward because the society never talks to them in a visual context.
NCBA mein hamara sabse pehla एग्जीबिशन लगा था और वहाँ पे एक अंकल जी आए थे जो फोटो देख के इतने आग बबूले हो गए. बहुत गुस्सा हो गया उनको कि ये हो नहीं सकता. इट वाज अ ग्रेट कॉम्प्लीमेंट क्योंकि उन्होंने काफ़ी गुस्से से पार्थो सर को कहा कि नहीं नहीं ये तो सब आपने किया, इनके नाम से आप यू नो यू आर रनिंग अ बिजनेस, और वो फिर दरवाज़ा पटक के चले गए.
Basically, I'm a lawyer, and most people thought I couldn't do law because I had low vision and I really had very bad sight and I couldn't read small print. Still, I decided to go ahead and do it, and I did it. When I've been traveling, people thought I wouldn't be able to travel, but I've traveled on my own wherever I needed to go. I have enjoyed underwater swimming. I have enjoyed a lot of other things which people thought I would never do. So this was just one more thing that people thought I couldn't, shouldn't, wouldn't, but did.
Very graphic. Graphic elements are there, graphic sense is there. I think it's a lot important for them to also know how people respond to their images. I think they will derive a lot, they will understand their images better based on how people have responded, sighted people respond to them. It's very important for sighted people to know how other people react. Why not them? I would say even more so them, because they are the ones who are courageous. They are the ones who are going into a space where they have no clue and they possibly cannot get any help.
all art belongs rightfully to the artist. However, a blind artist relies heavily on inputs and reactions from sighted people in order to comprehend and improve his art. Exhibitions held by blind with camera have allowed their art to be opened up to a variety of people, both sighted and blind.
I have to say I'm really impressed with the scale and perspective of the work. There's a unique point of view, and I think they're really nice images, even if you don't consider the fact that the people who are shooting them are visually impaired. A lot of the work are terrific images in their own right. So you don't have to give it that sympathy vote, whatever. If you just judge it as an image, some of it is really quite nice.
Every creator wants to see what he has created, right? And in terms of photography, I think the popularity of a digital camera is because it gives you an instant result that you can just see it immediately. Now, the same urge to see what they have created is there with the blind photographers.
Partho uses four techniques to make the content of the photographs available to the photographers. Along with braille write-ups for the blind, large print write-ups for those with low vision, there are also touch and feel tactile prints, which help the photographers get a view of what they have shot. There is also an audio description that can guide them through the touch and feel images in order to explain the emotional aspects of the picture, like color and mood, which cannot be touched.
Closed door. ये मुझे 100% गाइड कर रहा है कि कैसा मेरा लिया हुआ पिक्चर है नो इट्स वेरी हेल्पफुल फॉर मी क्योंकि मैं पूरे डोर को एशियाटिक लाइब्रेरी में जाके टच नहीं कर सकता हूँ क्योंकि वो बहुत बड़ा है तो यहाँ पे मैं इसको समझ सकता हूँ अच्छे से लॉक से लेके ऊपर तक सब कुछ मैं इसको ये प्रिंट में देख सकता हूँ
Interestingly, the touch and feel tactile images are created by deaf-mute artists at the Helen Keller Institute for the Deaf and the Deafblind.
It is my strength because मेरी पर्सनल लाइफ के बारे में अगर मैं बोलूँ तो मैं ब्लाइंड हूँ, इसलिए यहीं तक आया हूँ। शायद मैं गांव में होता तो अब साइकिल में वो फेरी वाला बन के रह गया होता। अगर मैं फोटोग्राफी कर रहा हूँ तो आज ब्लाइंड हूँ इसलिए शायद कर रहा हूँ। मैं म्यूज़िक में भी आया तो एक ब्लाइंड था इसीलिए आया, और आज मैं एक्यूप्रेशर थेरेपिस्ट मैसेर हूँ। इसलिए नहीं कि मैं सिंपथी से मैं ब्लाइंड हूँ इसलिए, पर रीज़न ये है कि मैं अपने आप पर ज़्यादा कॉन्सनट्रेट कर पा रहा हूँ, बिकॉज आई कॉन्ट सी बाय माई आइज। तो मैं अपनी इंटरनल आइज ज़्यादा खोलने की कोशिश में हूँ।
Helen Keller wrote, "The person who is severely handicapped never knows his own hidden source of strength until he is treated like a normal human being and allowed to shape his own life. For life is either a challenge or an adventure or nothing at all. I thank God for my handicaps, for through them I have come to know myself and my God and my people." Photography without sight, seeing with the ears, opening up the mind's eye, are not easy and definitely not effortless skills. It requires immense belief in one's instinct to be able to create a mental image of what might lie before one's eyes. To indulge in a form of art that requires one to delve into an unknown space and to come out of it victorious. It serves a purpose more than self-satisfaction. It builds self-belief, and most importantly, becomes a vehicle for social inclusion, a ray of hope for equal opportunities.
They are the ones who need to be responded to, because it's important, because something will come out of it. Something has come out of it.
The power of belief allows you to transcend unknown possibilities, to achieve unknown possibilities. That is your power of belief, that you can do it. How? It will come to you.
I don't want to cross barriers. I have no barriers. I want to do a thing, I will do it. And if it means photography, then somebody like Partha will walk into my life.
आप जो देखते हो तो उसका फिक्स इमेज आपके माइंड में है कि ये ऐसा है तो ऐसा ही होगा, बट विद ब्लाइंड विजन आप उसको काफ़ी डिफरेंट एंगल से, मुझे लगता है अलग अलग तरीके से सोच सकते हो।
आई वॉन्टेड टू बिल्ड अ स्मॉल स्टूडियो नियर माई हाउस फॉर फोटोग्राफी एंड आई थिंक दैट इज़ पॉसिबल बिकॉज आई कैन यू नो कीप द थिंग्स इन माइंड वॉट काइंड ऑफ problems will I face during clicking a photograph, and will people really trust me while if I build a studio?
I see photography by the blind as a great social equalizer, right? If they can do photography, if they are given an equal opportunity, okay, they can do at par with any able-bodied people.
खुले आँख से करोगे तो हमसे thousands से आप आगे रहोगे, undoubtedly. किसी दिन हम भी वहाँ पहुँचेंगे, अभी शुरुआत है. लेकिन अगर आप आँख बंद करके फोटोग्राफी करोगे तो आप हो सकता है हमसे 100 स्टेप पीछे चले जाएं।